What's up,
Wattsfam? What's up, Wattsfam? It's Sylvester the Cat.
My lips are dry.
Suffering clutching task.
My lips are dry. I need some water, probably, and some chapstick.
No, I'm not sure. You need some chapstick instead of trousers.
Good vibes on me. Good vibes to my homies. Good vibes. Good vibes.
What's up, Wattsfam? It's your girl Marijiah.
This your boy Ant.
And we are the Wattsfam. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button.
You can place any questions or comments down below.
Like the video, turn on the post notifications so you don't miss a video from us. In today's video, we are going to be talking about were we prepared for marriage. Before we get started, I do want to go ahead and shout out Life with the Glovers. You guys are our post notification shout out for
appreciate
this video. So we appreciate y'all for always liking and commenting and sharing love with us on our videos. So Life with the Glovers, y'all do us a favor. Y'all go subscribe to them and check them out. They're a really dope family.
Yep.
So before we get started,
okay,
on the video,
I'm ready. Whatever you finna say, I'm ready to jump in. I don't even know what you finna say, but I'm ready.
Before we talk about where we prepared, we need to make it apparent that we are not relationship gurus.
Okay, there we go.
We are not, you know, people who, you know, are perfect in our marriage and our relationship individually. We're not here to tell y'all how to do things. We're not here to tell y'all how not to do things. We are not here to tell y'all anything. This is strictly our opinion. This is strictly our relationship. This is strictly our marriage and how we've dealt with it, how we got through it, how we worked through our issues, and just being transparent and being open-minded about the things we have gotten through. This ain't to, you know, tell y'all didn't do this and not do that.
This is exactly how you gotta do it. No, we're not giving y'all no blueprint.
Yeah, that's just not what that is. Right. We don't think we know everything. We're just not credited, I feel like, enough to just be trying to give people advice because we're still trying to figure it out, you know?
However, if our story just so happens to touch someone who has a similar story or maybe going through something similar or maybe have dealt with something that's similar or may have had been like, man, you know, I thought I was the only one that felt like that. This is what this is for. And just in case you want to take it, that's cool, but this is not by any means what we consider any type of advice. You know, this is just open talk amongst, you know, married people, like hopefully people that's single that may, you know, just be like, okay, I want to see what a relationship is like or see what this type of relationship is like. Not everybody's relationship has their its own identity. We understand it.
So let's talk about it. Were we prepared for marriage? Do you want to go first or me?
Come on.
You go first because you always ask me to go first. Or you always tell me because the ladies first.
I don't tell you to go first. I just like for you to go first because it's for ladies. It's just courteous, being courteous. But if you prefer me to go first, I go first.
I think you should switch it up. You always ask me to go first.
Okay, I'll go first. It's fine. So the question was, am I prepared?
We prepared for marriage?
As a couple?
Individually or as a couple? Both. Were we prepared?
I wasn't prepared individually for marriage. Therefore, I don't feel like we were prepared as a couple. Because there was so much stuff that I thought I would be able to do or I thought would be easy to do that was like really, really a lot more difficult than I thought it would be. One is like sacrificing your time. Like me growing up in high school, I have a little sister, but we didn't grow up, you know, together. So I was kind of like an only child. I didn't have to worry about spending my time with anybody else. I was able to do what and whenever I felt like getting going, I can do anything. Like if I felt like coming home, doing my homework and going to my room, playing a game all day, that's what I did. If I felt like going to chill with my friends, that's what I did. It wasn't until now I have to start sharing that time that I'm so accustomed to being mine all the time with somebody else who's used to sharing her time because she grew up with three siblings and her parents, and so she used to interruptions and everything and having to switch and go do something else.
You mean two siblings?
Two siblings, yeah, you're right, my bad. Two siblings.
Gave my mom an extra child.
Well, Taylor's like two dudes, so. But that was an adjustment just in itself, just learning how to spend time, share my time with somebody. Then I gotta go with somebody who doesn't necessarily agree with a lot of the stuff I agree with on the regular. And it's like I gotta deal with this person like 24/7. Like it ain't no, okay, I'm gonna go back home. Like we arguing, it's like, all right, I'm gonna go back home. It's just like, I don't know, it was just completely different from doing something for 18 years and then having to switch, or not realizing that you're gonna have to switch and all of this is gonna be changing like really, really fast. And I think honestly, it's not that it's not hard to change, it's just you have to switch so fast. Like it has to be done, it has to be an abrupt switch unless you're gonna, if you're gonna make it work like right off the bat. And for most people, it's hard to just change something you've been doing for 18 years to now I gotta start doing something completely different and be efficient and consistent at it. You know, like going forward.
Oh, excuse me.
And it's just difficult to do. So I would say no for being prepared for individually and as a couple. I would say no.
I think just based off the last statement that you said, had we been prepared individually, then we wouldn't have had to worry about trying to do it so right. quickly. So that's the reason why you felt like it happened so quickly, because you didn't start sacrificing that time ahead of time. Even though you didn't have a girlfriend, you didn't start implementing it until you got a girlfriend. You get what I'm saying?
Right. That's the tricky part about dating and all of that stuff, because it's like a catch-22. Because for me, I don't know if I would have. I'm not gonna say if I would have ever, but I think I still would have been trying to figure out like who I am, and having somebody here to hold me accountable 24/7 to make me actually truly like take a look at myself is, I think it speeds up the process and it helps you a whole lot, as opposed to, you know, kind of moving at your own drum and not having really anybody to challenge that. It's kind of, you know, difficult, you know, to make those, to not carry any baggage. Man, you don't know, like, honestly, you don't know the stuff that you've dealt with in your past and stuff that might be traumatic to you until you like get with somebody else, until somebody starts calling out some of that stuff that you didn't even realize was even that big of a deal. Mm-hmm. And I mean, it just makes you take a long look at yourself and be like, man, I got a lot I didn't realize I had to work on. Now, some people find that within themselves or whatever before get into a relationship, and that's cool for those people, but I would like to think that for, you know, majority of the people, that it, you know, it may take them being with somebody else to make them see that, but that person still gotta be willing to change and all of it. Also,
I think that realistically that's what you would like to do, is to individually work on yourself prior to getting in a relationship. However, that isn't always the case. And I think, just to answer the question, were we prepared? Obviously, no. I'm gonna say no, we weren't prepared. And when I think about it, we weren't prepared because, number one, we individually didn't work on ourselves prior to. So, you know, getting married at, what, 23? And I can't remember, you were in 22. 26, 27, yeah, we were just getting the swing of things, you know, just figuring things out as far as like pre-adulthood, just getting into maybe starting a career or our employment where we kind of wanted to be, or what we thought we was going to be.
Right. thought.
Yeah, thought we was going to be. And then you just don't pre-plan what you should be working on individually before you get with somebody. And I think we spent several years dating, which was one thing, which was a good thing because we got to know each other. So from 2009 to 2016, during that time we were dating. So there was no planning for marriage because we wasn't even thinking about marriage. You know, we was literally thinking about dating, yep, having fun, yep, you know, going on dates, what's your favorite color, hanging out. Like, there was no getting married. The getting married or even thinking about getting married literally came years down the line. So we didn't even plan. We didn't even try to plan ahead to try and prepare for that.
And honestly, when I proposed, like, I wasn't even preparing myself for marriage. I was just like, it's time to settle down. Like, I know I want to be with her the rest of my life. And that was it. It wasn't no, okay, I know I want to be with her for the rest of my life. Let me start working on this. Let me start working, because I know this about myself, and I know I need to do this with myself. But it's like, at the time, like, I'm thinking, you know, I'm perfectly okay. I don't have anything I need to work on. I'm not even looking at it like she has anything she needs to work on at the time. We just both looking at it like, okay, we done had our little brush ups, our little bristles. It's like, we done got past that. So for us, we thinking, okay, that's gotta be it. You know what I mean? Like, we done. And at the time, we really haven't even been through what we thought we was like, was like going through at the time.
We were young. We didn't know. Right, we didn't understand. So that's what I'm saying. We weren't prepared because we were dating for so long. We didn't prepare then. Yep. Then you got to think about it. When you get engaged, what you working on?
The wedding. Yeah,
you ain't thinking about, okay, your marriage and what you should be working on. And I mean, yeah, you go to counseling. Yeah, we went to counseling. But I mean, we'd be realistic. It gave us some pinpoints and ideas on maybe how to have tough conversations, but as far as actually dealing with it and being in the real thing, it's totally different.
Yeah.
So you can take so much advice, and then when you get in that situation, you don't even use that advice.
Yeah.
You know? So then after the dating and then after the engagement, then it's the wedding. So the tough stuff don't, you know, sink in, or the real work doesn't really start until after you're home and it's just you and us and there's nobody at home but us, you know? And so, no, we wasn't prepared. Individually, I think we could have did a lot of preparing, you know, individually to help bring more of a successful marriage for the both of us. We both, prior to, did not work on ourselves. We brought a lot of baggage, you know, into the relationship.
And it wasn't on purpose.
Nah, it wasn't on purpose. I mean, we just brought a lot of things that we should have dealt with before then, you know, into the marriage, which made it a lot harder for us, because now you're dealing with, you know, old baggage, past relationships and past encounters. You know, we didn't talk about finances. Like, we just did not discuss nothing. It was just
We dove in that mud naked. We didn't have to know this.
That's what it was. I mean, it was really based on love. I mean, that's just really what it was. It was, I want to be with you want to be with me.
It was just, we know we love each other, so we ready to whatever finna happen, just finna happen.
That's what's supposed to happen. Yeah.
And we also just didn't think it was anything to prepare for. Like, we were just like, we know each other. Like, and it's like, we know people keep telling us that, like, marriage is hard work, but we just like, how much hard work can it actually be? Like, like, I know this person, like, she know me for the most part. Like, I know how her temper is. I'm like, I know she can be a little rowdy at times. I'm like, I think I can deal with that the rest of my life, because I feel like I'm calm in the times when she's rowdy, and I think she's calm in the time when I'm rowdy. But I'm like, I don't understand what it is, what's the big deal. But now, yeah, there's a lot of stuff, a lot more stuff.
Do you think that you're able to prepare for a marriage? Like, do you think you honestly can prepare for marriage? And if you do, how do you do that?
I think you should start with that. I answer the first one first. I think I would like to hear your thoughts on that question.
You just don't want to answer first.
It ain't that got nothing to do with me answering first. This is the game of chess, not checkers.
You don't got no answer. That's chess, what that is.
Chess, not checkers. I do have it. Come on, I already. Okay,
I'll go first. No, I'm gonna go. No, don't even do that. Do you think you could be prepared? I personally, this is my opinion, and y'all can hate me if y'all want in the comments.
We might disagree. We'll see.
I think you can prepare individually as a person, you know, as yourself, to have yourself aligned for a marriage, or for God to send you that person that he wants you to be with, meaning, you know, your finances any baggage that you have, you know, any relationships, you know, you have dated. If you have everything together individually, you've had your mirror moments, not saying that you're not gonna still have issues, but you've dealt with yourself and you know the issues that you have, you've worked on them, or even you're still working on them. I would say yes, individually. But can you prepare for a marriage? I personally feel like no. And the only reason why I say that is because I feel like you just don't know what's coming. You get what I'm saying? Like, so it's hard to prepare for something if you don't know what to expect. And so, yes, we could have done a lot of things better. We could have. But the things that we didn't work on individually, I feel like actually helped us more than it hurt us. Because then, for me, we both got to work on those things together. So when you didn't see yourself, I saw you. And then when I didn't see myself, you saw me. And we was able to help each other grow and learn and say, okay, you need to have a mirror moment, you know? So I don't think you can, I don't think you can prepare. And I do think that you can, you know, I think being in church, I definitely think prayer, I definitely think God, like all of that. And I'm not saying that that does not matter, because God's definitely head of our life and head of our marriage. But, I ain't even gonna say no but. Head of our marriage, individually, yes. Together, trying to plan for some, I'm gonna say no. My answer is just no. And, you know, and if I knew all the stuff that we was gonna have to deal with, I feel like we would've went through it with flying colors. You know, we would've raced through that mud super quick. But we didn't know that was coming. So we had so much growth and so many like errors and so many trial errors. Yeah. And we had a lot of stuff.
It's funny because, like, when you said that, it made me think about, like, man, what if God had given us like a checklist that we needed to work on and be like, hey, now that you've proposed, this is what you need to work on, you know, before you wear. Like, Anthony, you got anxiety a little bit sometimes, so you need to deal with your anxiety. Mariah, like, sometimes you don't listen sometimes when somebody already gives, like, it's just, I wish he had been like, look, this is what y'all need to work on. And I don't doubt that I would be like, okay, this is, oh yeah, let me go ahead and knock this stuff out real quick, you know, while we, but it's like, it just don't come that easy. And that's what I appreciate about our relationship, is because God has always been, had his hand around us individually as well as a couple. Mm-hmm. And I say that because both of us came from church backgrounds growing up. Well, both of us was raised in the church. So whenever we would stray apart, it's like one of us would always, even when it was, one of us would always go back to God and be like, look, we completely forgetting about God. And sometimes it'd be me, sometimes it'd be her. Mm-hmm. But that's what I appreciate so much about our relationship, is how whenever we going through it and the other one ain't thinking, just look, reach out on God. Like, one of us always does. I don't know why, I don't know how, but one of us always seems to do it to bring things right back into perspective. But with that being said, man, it would have been awesome to have a checklist, you know what I mean, to what to prepare for. But unfortunately, the beauty in it, like she said, is just knowing that you worked on it individually and as a couple. Like, I helped her with her issues individually, she helped me with my issues that I was dealing with individually. Even though we were a couple, some stuff I had to step back and let her handle, and let her, just her and God handle. Some stuff she had to step back and just let me and God handle. And
I think, I'm gonna be honest with you, a lot of the things that we address or talking about, I feel like we had an idea that it needed to be worked on, but we ignored the fact that it needed to be worked on. Because I can remember plenty of times before the wedding even came about, or preparing for marriage even came about, before we even got engaged, while we was dating, my parents, you know, telling me, watch your tone.
They told us so many times.
You know, I'm just talking about for me.
Oh, for you.
Like, for me, like, if, you know, we were over the house or whatever, and we was having a disagreement, watch your tone. Watch how you talk to him. Mirage, you're not listening, you know? And then I can even say for your dad and then your stepmom.
My dad and my stepmom for me.
Yeah, so. When we was here, I mean, when we were at their home and we would have disagreements or whatever, they would always say, watch how you talk to each other. You know, or you not understanding because you're not listening to what she's saying. You're just too quick. Yeah, you not understand. You just quick to respond. And so I think we heard those things individually, but we wasn't working on those things, which could have helped us prior to.
A long time ago.
Yeah, but we wasn't.
I think we were just too, at that time, we were just too focused on each other and we weren't focused on ourselves.
And I agree, I think so too.
And I think once we both realized that, I shouldn't be worried trying to help him work on him. I should be worried about myself.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like once we figured that out and we shift the focus from the other person to ourselves, that's when it seemed like everything started, you know, finally like gelling.
And I think that's why they say too, like when you have conversations, don't be so quick to look at the fault what the other person did.
Right.
You know, look at yourself and say, what did I do wrong? What could I have done better? Could I have said this better? Could I have,
if there's something caused this person to react the way they react.
Yeah. So. Like all of that I feel like played a part as far as us being prepared. But we didn't take any of that being young, trying to figure it out.
We didn't
Didn't care.
Sometimes
thinking you know everything or you know it all. Like I feel like all that played a huge factor in not being prepared. So were we prepared? No. Do you feel like you could get prepared? I personally say no.
I don't think you can, man. Like it just takes too many turns that you don't have the directions or you don't have no GPS for. Like it's just like you trying to figure it out. Like it's back to the Stone Age when we didn't have GPSs, man, to where it's just you and your memory and trying to figure out, okay, how did I get here last time? Okay, what should I not do? Okay, I shouldn't go this way this time, because this is what happened last time. Like, it's just really just trying to figure it out on your own.
Yeah, and I don't think you can literally sit and map out and say, okay, when, you know, A, B, and C happened, this is what we gonna do. And just because you mapped it out don't mean you gonna actually do that, what you mapped
out.
You
gotta think,
you
know? You're taking what you've been doing or how what you've been raised to do or what you've seen or the environment that you've grown up in coming up into that relationship.
Yeah.
But yeah, that just goes back to what I was saying about how you bring baggage and stuff that you was raised to do and different stuff that you needed to change about yourself into that. So that's why I say you don't figure out that, okay, maybe I've been doing this wrong for a couple of while. And it's not everything that you're raised to do, but it's just some stuff that it's like, okay, I don't have to do this, or you know, I don't have to say that, or this don't have to be my response every time, or this person ain't really attacking me.
Mm-hmm.
And because of how I grew up, maybe everything feels like an attack, because I didn't grow up in situations where I had to sit down and have communication and talk through stuff and tell how I'm feeling, because I would hold stuff in. And that's just what I brought into a relationship, is holding stuff in. I didn't bring in, okay, let's sit down and talk about it. I brought in, okay, you made me mad, I'm shutting down, I don't want to talk about it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's that baggage that we was talking about, you know, bringing in baggage and not going in with an open mind. Mm-hmm. Not going in with the mindset of change. You're not going in the mindset with a open mind that your partner is going to try and help you, you know, change or allow you to change. So shifting a little bit, understanding your identity, do you think going through all of that in that process that we changed each other? Or do you think I was trying to change you? Do you think I was trying to make you be like a different person? Like, how did you feel going through the process of having to do a lot of changing?
Just say in the beginning, it felt like you were trying to change me. Mm-hmm. In the beginning, it felt like that.
Mm-hmm.
But once I got to a point where I was now willing to change, I realized that you weren't trying to change me, that you were trying to help me.
Mm-hmm.
However, because of some of the ways that you were going about trying to help me,
mm-hmm.
was a little bit, you know, rough for mm-hmm. my life. You know what I mean? For me, for somebody who already don't dealing with trust issues. Mm-hmm. It's like, so, cause it's like, even though I was in a relationship, I still, because of my past, wasn't able to be fully vulnerable and be like, you know what, I'm open to having my feelings hurt. I'm open to, you know, being angry. I'm open to this, because I had to have my shield up, because it's like, I didn't like feeling like this. Mm-hmm. But I think you definitely helped me look at myself and helped me work on stuff that I used to have and that I let go, or either stuff that I didn't have and I obtained. I feel like there used to be a dog in me, a dog in me, to where I just didn't really, for real, care about anything anybody thought about me. And I feel like I lost it, you know, for a little while. And I think our relationship helped bring that back out of me. Mm-hmm. And be like, look, you got a dog down there in you, man. Like, you a go-getter, like, you a hustler. Like, mm-hmm. That was gone, you know what I mean? And so that helped rekindle that. So I would say absolutely it helped change. What'd you say?
I mean, I think so. I agree. I mean, I think that in the beginning, we both were looking at... I never thought you was trying to change me. I just thought that sometimes you weren't understanding where I was coming from. And I think that's where the miscommunication always happened for it us, would, you know.
And we would keep going in circles.
Yeah, we would just be going in circles and circles and circles. Sorry, y'all, the camera died. The devil don't want us to talk about this.
Right.
The last thing is, one of my friends sent me something about marriage. And so it says, before you get married, discuss bills, parenting styles, credit, debt, religion, how to deal with family, what beliefs would be instilled in your children, childhood trauma, sexual expectations, partner expectations, financial expectations, family health history, mental health history, bucket list, dream home, careers, education, political views, and whatever else comes to mind. Love alone is not enough. Do you agree?
I agree, because that's literally all we brought into it. Like, it's funny that, you know, they send stuff like that and it'd be a revelation to what, man, if I only knew, you know, before I started, because this is exactly what we were saying, like, before you read that. Mm-hmm. That's all we literally brought into our marriage, love. That's it. We didn't bring any of this. Like, mm-hmm. Some people were telling us this, but it's like we're so caught up in the love part of it, and just I'm just with my partner, I'm with my best friend, and that's all we think, and we're not thinking about all those. So we just think, oh, all those stuff will work out, because we always work stuff out together, and I'm not thinking that we got two different ways of dealing with some of this stuff.
Well, I'm be honest, I never thought that it was just like, oh yeah, we'll figure it out, oh yeah, this, you know, this would be, I never went in it thinking that way. Now, I knew that it wasn't going to be easy, but I had no idea that it was going to be as tough as it has been. Mm-hmm. You know, as far as being a young adult than young married couple. You know, my thought process was not, oh yeah, you know, it's going to be okay. You know, I think once we got in the situation, yeah, we figured it out. Mm-hmm. You know, but talking about a lot of these things that were mentioned, I think it definitely could have helped. You know, especially mentally, because going through the process, you know, I was mentally drained.
That's the first thing.
Yeah, mentally, I was mentally drained. Honestly, I was depressed. Like, you know, getting married at a young age is not a bad thing. So let me not say that it's a bad thing. But being mentally prepared, I wasn't prepared. And so I was going through a lot of individual issues. And then I came into the marriage, you know, having to pick up his issues, then put mine to the side. And so that was probably one of the darkest moments probably of my life, you know, from 23 up until what, probably like 26, you know, when we was actually going through some tough situations. And just now I'm coming, maybe 27, like I'm just now getting to the point where I'm seeing the other side of it, you know, and actually feeling like I feel good, you know, self-care. You know, we've made it through these issues, we've worked on them, and we know how to deal with things a lot better than we've ever had to,
I think the biggest thing is we've learned how to focus on ourselves within our marriage. Does that make sense? Mm-hmm. Okay. I'm gonna just focus on myself and I'm gonna let God handle it. We was too busy trying to fix each other instead of like letting God do it. Instead of saying what we need to say, praying about it and hoping that God, you know, gets us through. And it just seems like since we've started doing it, since we started giving each other space and being like, you know what, I'm gonna let them have it. Or we saying, you know what, I need my space, or I need my time, or look, I need to go talk to God real quick. Like, when we finally start doing that within ourselves, it just seems like everything started getting better.
Mm-hmm. I agree. We had a lot of positivity around us and a lot of positive couples that did, you know, help us work on what we needed to work on. But I think our parents played a big role.
A huge role.
You know, tremendous role.
Tremendous.
In our lives as far as, you know, a healthy marriage and going through, you know, tough times and tough situations. Mm-hmm. And so having our parents and having what a marriage looked like for us, it really helped us.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So that is the end of our video. I did not want it to be this long, but...
It's this long.
Yeah, so this is our where we prepared. Y'all don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Leave us a comment, like the video, turn the post notifications on so you don't miss
a
video from us.
Put some questions in the comments that y'all might be thinking of, or some questions that y'all have, you know what I mean?
Yeah, ask us some
questions. We may have experienced it. If we don't know, trust me, we gonna tell you we don't know.
Yeah,
but
I know.
I ain't never dealt with that before, so like, as much as I wanna help you out, I ain't got nothing on that one. So,
Yeah, leave us some comments, any suggestions on maybe topics you want to hear us talk about. Shout out to Raven because she sent me that text message about the beliefs and everything, and should we talk about it before the marriage, so I appreciate that. Until then, we'll see y'all in the next video. Wattsfam signing out. Peace.
Out.